So this is a steel design course. The first subject we will cover is tension members. As you can see, it's about four parts, four topics or four handouts. This handout is number one out of four. Number four will be like examples. I will solve four kinds of examples about all different design of tension members. So you can find tension members in trusses, towers, lifeline cables, suspension bridge, or any kind of tension member. We use structural steel shapes to design them. We're not talking about reinforced parts. We are dealing with structural steel members. It means the member by itself, section, is made of steel. Not reinforced concrete. Can be wide flange, WF, sometimes we call it W shape, which is an I shape. The flange, when I say flange, this is a flange. What do you call this? This is the cross section of a steel member. This is the cross section. If you cut, you see something like that. So it's kind of an I, right? This is different than an I section. The flange, this is the flange. Is wide, kbire, compared to my I section. So this section we call it I section. This is a wide flange section, W shape section. So if you want to do the extrusion, okay. So this is a member, and this is a cross section, wide flange. The flange is big compared with the flange of an I section. What do we call this one? If this is the flange.
Web.
What? Web. So that's a flange, flange, web. So that's a W, F shape. That's an I shape. This can be used for beams and columns or any tension member. This usually it has high amount of inertia. It's deep. We use it for beams. Okay. So when I say L for angle, that's an angle. Section. With this L or angle cross section. Can be equal leg. Both leg, this is a leg. Can be equal leg, thinking it bar, or unequal leg angles. Everything is standardized in the manual. All these sections are standard sections available for you. What you need is you need to calculate from structural analysis the ultimate load. If we are dealing with tension members, we are interested in calculating T ultimate or T ultimate from structural analysis. Then pick a section that can give you a strength more than T ultimate. We said the strength is it TM? That's the nominal strength. We don't design for the nominal strength according to the LRFD approach. We are following LRFD design approach, load and resistance factor design. Loads are factored by factors more than one, and the strength is factored by strength reduction factors less than one. So we have load factor and resistance factors. Okay? So TN is the nominal. If you take the member to the lab and you crush it in tension and bending, everything, this gives you the nominal strength. If we are dealing with tension member, so this is the nominal tensile strength. We don't design for that, we multiply it by the strength reduction factor, the phi factor. You want to call it phi, that's fine. The phi factor, phi TN is the design strength now. So TN nominal, phi TN design, TU ultimate. Design philosophy is always, always. You want always T U to be less or equal phi T M. Always the strength of the member must be greater than any potential combination of the applied load. يعني أكثر load ممكن تحطه عليه لازم يكون always less than strength that can be given for the member. Now there's two kinds of questions. either the section is given and you are asked check the adequacy of this section. You have a member, you will go YWF 12 by 35, any member is telling you check if this section is good or not. From structural analysis you calculate the ultimate. You go to the table, you look up that section, the table will give you how much the strength of that section. Or you use the equations that we will learn to calculate the strength of that number. If VTM greater than TU, good. If TU is greater than VTM, no good. Not safe. If the ultimate is greater than VTM, not safe. If this is greater than this, safe. But how much bigger? If this is too much greater than this, the section is over designed. The section is over designed, not economy. No economy in your design. Usually, we're trying to keep the section within 20% more than this. Not more than that. Unless you have to, for constructability. يعني عشان تخفف الكونستركتابيليتي. Okay? يعني مرات تحط section أكبر من section ثاني, cheaper than تحط واحد أصغر لأنه الكوست بيكون أقل. So sometimes to fabricate a bigger member costs you less than having a smaller member in terms of material or cross section. So this is the design philosophy. Remember, here we have load factors. Here we have strength reduction factor, resistant. Good. Both are designed based on probability-based approach such that the probability of failure is almost zero, 1 over 100,000. So the probability in 100,000 building, neat elf building, one probability that one of them will fail, or one member will fail. This is what we call LRFD approach. This is what we're gonna use. Okay? So what sections we use? What sections we use? I told you table 2-4. So this is the code and the manual. This is the AISC code and manual. So the first part of it is manual, giving you the dimensions, detailing, strength of each member, or standard section. Then there is something called specification. This one, this is the 14th edition. 14 edition. 13 is okay. You can bring the 13. It's black. The book will look black. 13th edition. Some of the things that we refer in the handouts need to be changed. يعني تغير صفحة واحدة اثنين. Okay. We can look them up and change them. So this is specification. All the books are based on this specification. This is the code. And this is the manual. So if you want to look up what material we use this from, so we have table 2-4. What does it say? Applicable ASTM specifications for various structural shapes. You know what's ASTM? American Society for Testing and Materials. American Society for Testing and Materials. They give specification or reference to each material. So you can see here, W shape, the wide flange, M shape is a structural shape, S, C, MC, L, rectangular or HSS, round, all kind of structural shapes. Table 2-4, okay? So you can see here, this is the designation of the material, A whatever, A992, A36. These numbers are arbitrary. They don't mean anything. يعني ما لهم معنى. They are arbitrary. Okay? يعني واحد حط الكود. They don't give you any indication about the tensile strength or the yield strength. Good? So then you will see, there's many grades of each material. You can see. As you can see here in the table, there's black. There's some cells are filled with black, then there's gray, then there's white. Black, it means this section is always available. Call, they will ship it to you. Order, gray, need previous order. If you need section to use from the grave or any of these sections, you have to call 6 months ahead. Why we don't do it? Not available. Don't waste your time and design with that. Remember, this thing, we are just looking for the grade of the material. Fy and F ultimate. Because remember last lecture, we have what we call limit states. We have limit states. What's the strength? Based on the limit state. We have yielding and rupture or fracture. Anyway, so let's call W section. Most of the used sections are W section, wide flange section, W. What's the best material to use the wide flange from?
A992.
See the black here? It says A992. What's Fy for A992?
50.
What's F ultimate?
65.
Good. So if I tell you design a set at A992 W section, you should be able to go and get Fy and F ultimate for that section. Good. So what's the best section for L?
A36.
A36. What's Fy for A36?
36.
This is the only section that works for you. يعني L 36 36. بعدين غيروها. After that become arbitrary. A36 only the A36. Fy is 36. KSI. What's F ultimate?
58.
How much?
58.
58. Do you know what does that mean? You know what does that mean? You know what's what we call a stress strain diagram for steel? Stress strain diagram. And if I make one a small piece of this material, okay, with a cross-sectional area of 1 inch square, round. Then I take it to the machine, then I apply direct tension. I apply direct tension, force, tension, till I break. Did you do this in the material course? Load. There is a strain gauge to measure the strain, right? So you have the load deflection. The load deflection. From the load you get the stress. How? By dividing by the cross-sectional area. From the deflection you get the strain by dividing by the gauge length. The gauge length, delta L over L. Good? So you have what we call a stress-strain diagram. For steel, it's linear elastic up to the proportional limit, right? Then nonlinear elastic slightly, then there is an upper or lower and lower yield, right? Then you have something like that, then it starts going like this. Then there is the rupture, ultimate, yield, Fy, F ultimate. So okay, the book used like this, the manual, and Fy. And this is the rupture. This is the strain, the ultimate strain. This is the strain, epsilon, and this is the stress. Good? So when we said for A36, this Fy is how much? 36. And F ultimate how much? 58. More than 1.5. And after the yield of A36, it takes a lot of stress after that. Before, and it's not gonna break there. يعني once you reach F58, is it gonna break?
No.
Hadid, ما بنقدر. No, it's not. Here. This is the 58. Did it break? This is the rupture. Then there will be something called softening. Okay? There is the necking. The actual, by the way, the actual. You know, there's the engineering stress diagram. There is the theoretical. You know what's the difference between this and this is the actual. This is the engineering. You know what's the difference?
And then the cross-sectional area.
Everything here is divided by the initial cross-sectional area. Here, if you divide by the actual cross-sectional area after necking, the area becomes smaller. So when you divide by that smaller, this is the actual. Anyway, you took all of that. Just to give you an indication, A36, 36 KSI, start yielding, 58 to reach the ultimate. And this is safety after that, okay? But this is what we designed for. This is for the fracture or rupture limit state. This is for the yielding limit state. So if you have a tension member, plate is used as a tension member. There is tension force. See, tension force applied on this member. This member is connected through bolts. Two bolts here or four of them. Depend. This must be designed. The number of bolts must be designed later on when we design connections. Okay? When we design connections. Good? So this plate usually is specified by the width. Plate, let's say 8 by 1/2. This means something. When you see a plate 8 by 1/2, it means the width is 8 inch, the thickness is 1/2 inch. Okay? How many components this plate have? يعني كم كيس عندها؟ One. All of it is connected. When I say when you have an angle, it has two legs or two components. You may connect one leg or both legs. Okay? You may connect one leg or both legs. This is has something. There is a factor for that. If you connect one leg, not all the components, there is something called shear lag factor. You will see it in the design. How about the wide flange, the I section? Look at this. Okay, you may connect with row of bolts here and here. They can be 3, can be 2, can be 4, and one here. Okay, so this is the top flange, this is the bottom flange. You may connect the top and bottom flange. How we connect them? We may have a plate coming here and a plate coming here, connected to the member. Good? Or to the gusset plate. So, all of the parts are connected or not? All of them are connected?
No,
web is not connected. Web is not connected. So if you connect the web to, then all of the parts are connected. So the shear lag factor U, you will see it later on, equal 1. If you connect all the components of the member, then U, the shear lag factor, there is no shear lag factor. The stress will be distributed uniformly on the cross section. Good? So let's go back here. We said there is two limit states. Limit states. Or we call it strength limit states. The first one is what?
Yielding.
Yielding of what? It's a steel. Yielding of what? What? Gross cross-sectional area. Gross cross-sectional. Sorry, gross cross-section. When? Where? Away from the connection. Somewhere here, along the length of the member, not at the connection. Why this is important? يعني, when it yield, why we call it failure? Think about it. When you have yielding, okay, the strain reached F1, right? So how much is the deflection? The strain, the yield strain times the length of the member. Delta equal what? Strain times the length, right? Or strain equal what? Delta L over L. So you want delta. Strain equal yield strain. Times the length. Think about it. For this one, delta equal what? Epsilon Y times the length. What's epsilon Y for steel? 0.002. 0.00207. 067, whatever. This is for grade 60 steel or 420 megapascal. Here we have structural steel shapes. For FY, how much, for A992, how much FY was?
36.
50 KSI. For A36 was? 36. In general, what's epsilon for steel for any material in the linear elastic portion? Hooke's law. Epsilon equal sigma over E. What's E for steel? Doesn't change. E for steel does not change. Everything here in kip inch, because all of this table is in kip inch. 29,000 KSI. The 29,000 KSI. To change it to megapascal, multiply by 7. 200,000 megapascal. Good? So this number E for steel, 29,000 KSI. It's like your name. يعني تطلع من هنا بعد 10 سنين تعرفش إلى steel, ارجع عيد steel. Every class you should know what's E for steel. 29,000 KSI. Good? Okay, for A992, how much Fy? How much Fy? 50. Look, we are here. Look into جماعة stress strain diagram. Stress strain diagram is very simple. Stress strain diagram is like the name of the material. يعني مثلا اسم محمد, this is the name of the material. The stress strain diagram is the name of the material. You should know everything from here. Right? So what's this point here? What's this? This axis reads strain. So what's this? Y. So whatever yield you have, what's this? Slope is E. So this is 50 over 29,000 KSI. So you get a number. You get a number. Very small. Strain is small. But when you multiply it by the length, you multiply it by the length, if the member is 20 feet long, the tension is 20 feet long. So 20 feet times 12 inch. 20 times 12 times the strain, which is 0.02 almost, 0.02, times 20 times 12, you will have a big deflection, a deflection that you can see in the eye. You see the member sagging or deflecting. Sagging يعني deflecting down. Okay? So it's called failure. That's failure. That's annoying, not safe. It also put the structure at the joints in some loads. So that if the cross section yields, that's failure. Away from the connection. But at the connection, why you don't care about it? How much the length of the connection? Small. Even if yields occur here, we don't care about it. We don't care about it. Because when you multiply that yield strain 0.02 by how much? Like half foot or 1 foot? Which is 12 inch, is nothing. The deflection is not noticeable. We cannot even notice that deflection. You understand? So there is two limits there. The gross, the yielding of the gross cross-section away from the connection. We said, so the strength, this strength is what? This strength, yielding strength, phi, Tn, yielding, for this, I'm saying yielding, equal what? What's the phi factor for yielding? Is yielding safe, failure mode or not? Safe. Yielding always safe. Fracture, different. Ductile, safe. Sudden or brittle, not safe. Shear, always not safe. Bending, failure, safe. There is science, it takes time. Shift to cable, did you see after yielding how much safety we have? In the stress strain diagram? The distance from yielding to the ultimate is ductility. How much ductile the member? It's safety factor. Safety factor. So Tn equal. So the phi factor for yielding is high, 0.9. That's the highest you can get most of the time. So the phi factor for yielding is 0.9. Is it what? Yielding of what? Gross cross section. So what's the area? AG. The gross cross sectional area of the member. Given. Given the first part is the first part in the manual is called DIM, dimensions for every section. So you start with W shapes, then he goes. So he tells you here, W16 by 100, the area is 29.4 inches squared. That's the area here. That's what you need. Give you X bar, Y bar, IXX, IYY, all of that. Good? So A gross for a section given for you. Remember, There is two types of problems. There is analysis and design. There is analysis and design. Assume that a section is given to you. يعني واحد معطيك section. Calculate the design strength of this section. How much this section can take? It means you have all the information. It means you have the gross. You have everything about the cross section from the manual given. Like for the plate here, we have the area. We have the area. How much? 8 times half, which is 4 inch square. So that's it. That's A gross. And that's the P factor, strength production factor. Of what? From the name. Yielding. What F you need? FY. FY. So usually those plates are made of 836. Usually they are made of 836. This should be given information to you. You should know what's the material. So this one is known times FY. So if you want to know how much the limit state or how much this one takes if it's about to fail in yielding, 0.9 times 4 times 36. 0.9 times 4 times 36. Check. Remember, what's the unit of 36?
KSI.
You know what's KSI? K per square inch. K على inch square. K over inch square. What's the unit of A?
Inch
square. So you have inch square at the top. Cancel. So what's the force?
Kip.
One kip, how many kilonewton? That's KSI to megapascal. One kip.
Seven.
One KSI. KSI is stress, not a force. KSI or megapascal, it's a unit for stresses. Kip for forces. Pound for forces. Newton for forces. Kilonewton for forces. I'm saying one kip, how many kilonewton?
Seven thousand. 4.45 kilonewton.
You don't need it here, but it's good to know it. One kip is bigger than the kilonewton, so you know kip is bigger than kilonewton. Okay? One ton in the metric system is how much?
1,000 kilograms,
which is 10 kilonewton. 10 kilonewton. Good? One ton. Or 1,000 newton. 1,000 kilograms. Multiply it by 10, you get 10 kilonewton. So one ton in the US system or the British system is how much? 1,000 pounds?
No.
One kip is 1,000 pounds. What's the ton? Ton to pound. 2,000 pounds. Two kips. Ton to pound. 2,000 pounds. Anyway. So how much we have here? How much we have? Did you calculate this? About 130. So if you apply 130 kip, you can fail this angle. This is huge load, by the way. This is a lot of strength. And steel members, imagine, that's 8 inch. By half inch, that much plate can give you 130 kip strength. Good? So these are holes. 8 times half, that's the
width.
The plate. The width is 8 inch, the thickness is half inch. So the area is 4 inches square. Where is the 8 here?
Oh.
That's how we write the designation. I have a name about plate. This is how we write it. 8 by 3 quarter, 3 eighth, 1 inch, 2 inch. You write the width by the thickness. Standard. Okay? So that's the yield limit state. That's not the strength of the tension. You need to check the fracture or the rupture. The rupture limit state. Second one is, I'll do it here. To rupture of the net cross section. The net cross section. Where? At the joint. At the connection. Net at the connection. You have net, why? Because you have holes. These holes are punched for, there's something called standard hole. They are standard hole. يعني إذا بدك تحط برغي أنت في في هول تعمله the same size البرغي والأكبر شوي. The size of the hole is slightly bigger than the size of the bolt. Imagine you have half inch bolt. عندك البولت half inch. Okay, نص inch. If you punch a hole for that, slightly bigger. You know how much? 1/16 of an inch more. Additional 1/16 inch. It's small. And we make it slightly bigger than the bolt. 1/16. But when you punish them, wait. When you punish them, the punishing method, we expect to damage small tiny area around that. Additional 1/16. فبطلع السايز تبع الهول bigger than the size of the bolt by how much? dB plus diameter of the bolt plus 1/8 of an inch. 1/8 of an inch, you should know where did it come from. 1/16 extra, 1/16 from the fabrication method. Punching method, good. So when you calculate this one, you subtract this one from the width, how much? The diameter of the bolt plus 1/8 of an inch. Good? So now, look, if you apply tension here and you want to fail it, if you want to fail it, we said either you fail the gross cross section yielding, we checked that, or fracture somewhere here, or rupture here. If the rupture to occur, it will cross the bolts. It will cross the bolts. So the area is not the gross area in tension. Even if you have bolts, when you apply tension, they go away from the bolt. Bolt with all the hand. When you apply compression, the bolt heads. It's like the area is full. Right? When you apply tension, the gap or the hole go away from the bolt. If you apply compression, we're not dealing with the compression later on. You apply compression, the bolt head filling the material. So the area here, if there is compression, still the gross area. In compression, there is no net area. Good? So now look at the area here. So let's write the formula now from the name. So Vtn for rupture is not the same. You can say R for this one, Vtn for rupture. And the previous one you call it Vtny. But if you write it under the yielding, I know yielding, then I know this one. So this is Vtn, the design strength for considering the rupture limit state equal. There is a phi factor. How much do you think the phi factor is, bigger than the yielding or lower? This happened suddenly. This failure happened suddenly. Sudden. It's rupture. There is no signs. No safety. So we always, when we are afraid, we always use lower strength reduction factor. Remember the other day when I said, if we have uncertainty about the load, we use higher load factor. And load factor for the dead load, usually 1.2 dead load, 1.6 live load. Why we use 1.6 for the live load? Because we have higher uncertainty here. Likewise, depending on the nature of the failure, if the nature is dangerous, which is sudden failure, we decrease the strength reduction factor. If we have good confidence, yielding, safe, not bad, we go higher safety factor. Remember, this is money. It's like you are buying something from people, you tell them, I'm going to pay you 90% from the weight. Yeah, this is money to decrease. So how much do you think?
0.75.
The phi factor for the rupture limit state is 0.75. Then look, rupture means F ultimate. F rupture, F ultimate. How much? It depends. But that's Fu. Remember in the previous one was Fy. This is Fu. Of what? The net cross section. Look, listen to this. It's going to be AMU. Wait. Those two together, we call them AE, effective. So So the formula will be 0.75 FUAE, effective. Effective AE equal AM, the net, which is A gross minus the holes, times U. What's U? I just mentioned. The shear lag factor.
How many members are connected?
If all the parts are connected, one. If not all the parts are connected, it depends on how many rows of bolts you have, what's the length of the weld. There is a table, full table, I will show it to you next time, how to get this value. So that will tell you for the angle, use that, for the double angle, use that, for wide flange, use that. Everything is tabulated for you. يعني الجماعة, you just pull from the manual. How much that? يعني each component you look for. Where are we going to get this from? From the manual. Table 2-4. Where are we going to get this from? From the manual, the dimensions, based on the section. This from. Manual. If all the components of the member are connected, yani for the angle, both legs are connected. For the wide flange section,
both flanges and width.
Flange and width. For the HSS, each box or rectangular section, all of it around connected, welded all around or something. All the parts are connected. Fi formula for it. Yani fi formula, we're gonna write the formula for it, or we can approximate or use like standard values in the table. Good? Good? So the plate here, how much U?
One.
It's one component. All connected. One. Good? So if we apply for this plate here, phi Tn rupture equal 0.75. Assume A 36. How much of ultimate for it we said?
58.
This is the manual, the new one. This is the one that you covered. Guys, you should have sticky notes. Small sticky notes. I mean, just put a sticky note, table 2-4 for material, tensile and fracture, rupture strength. Another sticky note here for W shapes. Another sticky beginning of L shapes. Bring sticky notes. Sticky notes. يعني ورق لسي بتحطه بتنزله من جوه ماشي؟
No. It has a range.
Which one? 58
to 80.
Yeah. Look. He said there is a range. The manual تبعه. Good. Where is it? شوف تبعه. Says 58 to 80. في عليها superscript. Superscript يعني بيكون شيء فوق الرقم. نسميه superscript. تحتيه نسميه subscript. يكون تحتيه كاتب لك كود. If there is nothing mentioned about what's of ultimate, which one you take?
The smallest.
يعني it ranges from 58 to 80. There is nothing, no, I'm not telling you this plate is made of A36 with FU equals 70. I'm not saying. If I don't say it, you go, you pick the smallest value. I mean? So 58 times AM times 1. Now assume this 3/4 of an inch bolts, standard bolts. Okay? Some of you will graduate thinking that this member will fail this way, you don't know how the member will fail. There's a tension member. Member going from that corner to that corner. يعني جاي من الزاوية للزاوية. Truss member. ماشي؟ في tension. أنا ماسكه هون. These bolts. Bolts here and here. When you pull it, if it's fractured, always the failure is perpendicular to the direction of the load. You know this? The failure is always. If I pull this way, break this way. Always. If there is a crack in the wall, this way, what stress causes this crack? Always break something. They can't do it. You have to. This is sheer. This is sheer. This is different. Anyway, so what's AN here? Let's do it here. What's AN?
AG.
It's AG minus area of holes. Okay. Equal. How much AG? 4 minus. How many holes we have here?
Four.
Lost?
Two.
Either the failure will occur here or here. Two. And I have two bolts here and two bolts here. Either those will break or those will break. So two holes. So two. What's the area of the hole?
DB plus 1/8.
Okay, I will show you the cross section here. If you don't, if you can't imagine this cross section, let me know. This is the working cross section. This is gap. These are the holes. This is the remaining cross section. Okay? How much this one here?
Diameter of the hole. DB
plus
1/8.
Good? So, but what's the area? This area? The one that we need to remove?
Thickness with them.
This times the thickness of the plate. So this will be going back 4 minus, we have two of them, times the length of it. It's, now imagine when you look at it, you don't see a hole, you see a rectangle, right? So that's the length, that's the lost area, this rectangular area, the lost from the cross section.
2 times 7/8 inches.
So diameter, we said 3/4 of an inch plus 1/8 inside, sorry, 1/8. Inside times half. So this is the area, half times this. Again, this is 3/4 plus 1/8 of an inch. 3/4, 1/8 diamond, 7 plus 1/8. Yani most of the bolts we use 3/4. Okay? So always when you add 3/4 plus 1/8, for some reason, shabab khalat fiha. Good? So how much this area? AM. This is AH, so AM equal A gross minus AH. So how much? How you ended up with area bigger than the gross?
3.125.
He says 3.125 inches squared. غلط صح؟ غلط. صح ولا غلط؟
صح.
Makes sense. Makes sense. Yeah, you should get something less than that. Makes sense. Okay? So how much? Okay guys. The only calculation in the design attention numbers is AM and U. Like after that the design is so easy, straightforward. 0.9. A gross of Y. 10.175. AE FU. FU is given to AE. فيها نوعين. فيها AM. فيها U. AM here. A gross minus it holds. U, there is a formula. We didn't know him, but there is a formula. So how much the strength will be? 175. Do it for me. 175, 58 times 3.125. The answer will be in kip. If you use everything in kip or KSI and inch square, the force will be in kip. So the rupture, it will rupture at what force? So it will yield before rupture. So this member, this plate, will not rupture. It will yield before. And that's failure. Before rupture. So what's the design strength of this plate?
130.
So the design strength is the lesser of the two. One second. What's the design strength? This one control. The desired strength 130. This member, if T ultimate more than 130, is no good.
Kilobound.
Okay? That's it. It's not kid. It's kip. Kip. Here, pound. When you write it by itself, you write it LB. Abbreviation. But it's pound. B. Good? So now you know the fundamental concept. Good. The rupture, the limit state, the design strength, cross yielding, rupture, AM. The only thing we need now, next time, to clarify our ego is how to calculate you. And do other scenarios for AM. And analyze it.